Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to today's realistic review in which we are taking a look at the Swedish B17B sitting at 1.3 beta rating. What a B17 at 1.3? Well, this is a Saab 17, of course, or a Saab 17, or Saab. Anyway, the B17B is its call sign. And it is a very nice dive bomber or attacker, however you want to call it, for the Swedish Lion at 1.3. It has decent speed for a attacker at sea level without web, 311 kilometers an hour. With web, 324 at 4,500 meters. Still go up to 295 without web and 300 with. And finally at 6,500 meters, still go up to 247 without web and 250 with web. Now, this is faster than many of the biplanes. And, well, its cruising speed isn't fantastic in up tiers, but in down tiers, she's definitely fast enough to outrun quite a few planes. So there is that. Of course, there is a lot of planes that are faster as well, but you know, you can't have it all in an attacker. There, that is something that you can definitely say. Now, these speeds are in indicated airspeed without mech. The top speed in a dive in this plane is 589 kilometers an hour before she redlines and 650 before she rips apart. That is fantastic at a 1.3 battle rating. In an attacker, she doesn't have an air brake, unfortunately, otherwise she would be uber. But at a certain point she starts to slow down the acceleration in a dive, so it's very difficult to get to the 600. And it takes a while, so you do have enough time to drop your bombs off and to identify any targets. You can boom and zoom a little bit that way as well, which is quite nice. She doesn't have fantastic energy retention in the vertical. That's actually pretty bad. So she doesn't hold her energy well. Only in the horizontal in a straight line with web will she hold her energy decently well. Pretty good actually. The control stiffening. Is it effective dive speed? That's 650. Control stiffening starts at 350 with the first tick in the roll rate, especially the roll rate. And at 500 you get the second tick, which is pretty severe. Becomes more difficult to roll after that to get guns on target or to adjust for a bombing target. But the elevator still works very well and you can easily get out of the dive still at that point. The stall speed in this plane isn't particularly good. It is 160 kilometers an hour. So yeah, pretty heavy plane, especially when you compare it to some of the fighters. So even the biplanes can probably do better than this plane in vertical energy retention. So be very careful, exploit your piloting skills in the lower levels to get this plane to do well, the kind of things that I'm doing here, trying to defeat a very nice rolling biplane in a dogfight. Actually happens this time, but against any equal pilot you will have a definitely hard time in this plane. But well, he does have some tricks up her sleeve. The firepower in this plane is average, but she, well, I would say actually above average, because it's two 8mm KSP M22 machine guns for the Swedish. Quite nice, these machine guns, 500 rounds per gun. She also has a turret with an 8mm KSP M2237R machine gun with 300 rounds for the gun. Not the greatest ammo load on the back gunner, but still quite enough. The plane is also capable of several bomb loads. You start off with 9 50-kilogram bombs, then you have a 250-kilogram bomb, and you have a 250-kilogram bomb with 4 50-kilogram bombs. But I personally prefer the 9 50-kilogram bombs, because you have better results that way in attacking a column. And I like attacking columns in this plane. I think that's the primary role of this plane. Good ammo loads though on those guns, and the bomb loads are quite good as well. So all in all, very nice for the armament on this plane. The acceleration in the plane in a straight line is below average, and in a dive it's actually decent. Initially she needs to work up to a certain speed, but after that weight starts pulling in. And Yeah, it becomes decent at dive speed. The energy retention in the horizontal is very good. And in the vertical, it's bad though. So that's a very strange difference there. In the horizontal, when you come out of a dive and you web your plane up, then you will have very good energy retention and you can get home. Outrunning most of the biplane, especially on her own battle rating or on a down tier against 1.0 biplanes, you have very good chances to have a second run, which is very important in these kind of attackers because you get very, very nice results this way. In the vertical though, it's bad. As you saw, you lose a lot of energy when you go into the vertical. So vertical maneuvers are definitely not recommended, although you know, it's something you have to do sometimes, and you can even win. Sometimes it's an advantage because you stall out a little bit right above a plane who can't quite point up the gun, and then it's nice, but it can be detrimental sometimes, of course, as well. The climb rate in this plane is above average, which is very nice, because when you get back to the airfield, which I said you can easily do most of the time, because you, with the speed of this plane in a dive, you can get to the targets, you can do your bomb run, go for a column, get the column, get your bombs out, get results, and turn around and go back to your own lines, get a refill, and then climb up to a certain altitude and then do it again. This is possible in this plane, especially if your team survives and stays busy and you have low hanging enemy planes and you can climb above them. So yeah, very beneficial, very good in this plane that way. The turn time in the plane is also above average with flaps. It's decent. The flaps do rip off though at 420 kilometers an hour, which is well, it's actually quite good. Of course, in a dive you can run up to that speed quite easily, but in a straight line you won't get over that. And in most dogfights, as you lose speed, you will not get above 450 just like that. So those flaps do make the difference. They have also good effect on the turn time. So decent turn time with flaps. The roll rate though in this plane is quite bad. She also rolls off center, so you have a little bit of a wobble while you roll. This can be problematic, but you just have to be aware of it. You can deal with it. As my squad mate here had some problems with his 3 BF-109s, or I don't know, I'm actually not sure if it's 3 BF-109s, it's at least it's 2, but there's 3 planes here, and this plane is an excellent support plane. You have those 2 forward facing guns, you have the same armament as many of the Japanese 1.0 1.3 battle rating planes, 2 guns with a good amount of ammo, and if you are not the focal point of the dogfight but you can just come in and help somebody out, then you can still do a lot of good. And even still not being the focal point, you can turn and, you know, execute a little bit of shenanigans here and help your teammate out. So there is that. The overall maneuverability is average. As I suddenly shoot 2 planes out of the sky, nice. Overall maneuverability is average. The overheating in the plane is bad. It overheats quite badly. The oil is the culprit here. Oil overheats quite quickly and it definitely needs management. Durability overall is good and it can take a lot of damage, this plane. This plane is really a dive bomber and a column attacker basically. I wouldn't go and bomb the bases with this thing. That is a shame of a good plane. You have to go after the columns, which this plane is perfect for, to reach them with this speed, and you have enough speed to get the hell out of there as well. You do have to be careful in up tiers because the planes you will face there are a little bit faster than the most of the planes you'll face at its own battle rating. But you can get out of most situations, and in most of my matches I did get a second run on another column, and that is amazing for grinding options. So the B-17 for me is a very nice grinder, when attacking columns, and you can get very good results with that. It also has two attacking guns, and if you take a few teammates and fighters, you can support them when they're in trouble. You know, the plane can climb a little bit, and it has very good energy retention, and that is its main strength. The top speed in a dive and the energy retention in the horizontal make sure that you can get a second run in, which is excellent for grinding. And yeah, I quite like this plane because of that. It feels very sturdy as well. It has good durability. Overheating is not so nice though, especially the oil is overheating a lot and quickly as well. But all in all, this plane is well, one of my favorites actually in the Swedish rank 1. It really is a unique, nice looking plane that is a joy to fly. Yeah, go after the dough here. When you throw off your bombs and you have nothing else to do, go for your fellow attackers and have some fun. Why not? It's all in the game. And this B-17 definitely made a name for itself in my book. It is it's a very nice plane. Let's go back to base. Or shall we help my ally there? Well, no, the match is almost over. Chow can handle himself, right? 2 kills again in this match. I'm actually running a 2.5 positive kill death ratio in this plane. So, yeah. Nice going. Let's see what we got. We got a special reward and no, not a talisman, unfortunately. Backup vehicles, of course. Why not? We got best squad, 6,000 or almost 7,000 Silver Lions at 3,000 research points. I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. This plane, the Saab 17 or the B-17B, is a joy to fly. A plane that can fill many roles. It can attack, it can support, it can be a fighter in some occasions. It has forward facing guns, 2 of them with good ammunition. It has good top speed in a dive. It has very good energy retention in the vertical. And well, as I said, nice bomb loads with nice 9 50 kilogram bombs. It can perform very well in the dive bombing role and attacking columns. It overheats a bit. It has some other downsides. Not fantastic turn time, but still above average. Roll rate isn't too great. Overall, the acceleration and the energy retention in the vertical aren't too good. But if you use this plane to its strengths, she will do you a lot of good. And she can be a great grinder for the Swedish line. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video. Do leave me a comment. And if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.